Welcome to the first episode of Show Me Your Shorts, where each week we show short films and highlight the filmmakers that make them. This week we feature the filmmaking duo James Luckett and Tracy Tartt. Later in the show, we take you to the Atlanta Film Festival, where we saw a wonderful new film featuring Nicolas Cage and spoke with some very talented actors, directors, and crew. I'm Joyce White, and you're watching Show Me Your Shorts. You all doing this evening?
I'm doing all right.
This evening.
How, well, how are you doing today?
I'm doing very well. So silly. Good. First, I want to thank you for joining me tonight on the show.
Good. You're welcome.
Good to be here.
Well, that's good to know.
Good to be here.
All right. First, I want to ask, because you're the one that wrote the actual film.
Yeah.
How did you come up with that story?
I don't know. Probably just watching TV and listening to friends gossip on the phone, and I just kind of wanted to do something for shock value a little bit, you know, so you can have something to say, okay, what would I do in that situation? Or how would I advise my friend if that were her in that situation? And I just really, I just wanted something to kind of blow your mind a little bit. Just wanted to blow your mind out of the water.
And trust me, it did.
I hope so.
So, have you always wanted to be a writer of films?
No, I don't think I always wanted to write films. Mm-hmm. I think that desire kind of came up a little recently, but I always, you know, I always love films. I always like watching movies, and I always like, you know, the symbolisms and the way that they place things in movies. But I think writing the movies just actually came up recently. But yeah, I do love movies.
Yes, me too. I'm a fan of movies too. So like I said, I always enjoy just spending my times at home, you know, watching as many films as I can.
Yeah, me too.
Wow.
When we were growing up, my my aunt, she would keep us in the summer, and it was this, they had this store called Farmore. I don't know if you're familiar with Farmore. It's kind of like Target. And they had like a movie section, and you could rent 6 movies for $2.
Oh, wow.
And she would spend like $5. And, you know, she would get like, what, 12 movies and a bag of popcorn or something. And we would just watch movies. And they were called, they were like B movies. I think they called them B movies, low budget movies. But all in all, they kind of fueled some creativity, so. Here I am.
Now, speaking of, you said the word budget. Was there a big budget for this film? Was it simple to shoot?
It was about $20 for the cake.
Oh, see? Okay.
$20 for the cake.
So you didn't have to pay anybody for the location or anything?
No, we didn't have to pay anybody. I think people just wanted to participate, you know. I think they know the money will come later. If we keep at it, the money will come.
Yes, yes, it will.
Yeah.
And James.
Yes, ma'am.
You shot the film and directed the film.
Yes, ma'am.
How was that for you?
Oh, it was great. It was great. But let me backtrack on what she said. She called me up. I'm going to tell you the history of how that script came.
Okay.
She called me up one day. I was at work, and she cussed me out.
Okay.
She said, James, I'm ready to do something. I'm tired of playing. You know what I mean? People dragging their feet, blah, blah, blah. I said, okay, I tell you what. You bring me a script. You write something. Bring me a script, and I shoot it. We'll shoot it.
Okay.
So she called me up. Well, how long it take you? A couple of days? About a week?
I think it was about 3 days.
About three days. She came back and sent me the email, sent me the script. And I was like, okay. Because it was just like a conversation. You know what I mean? I was like, we could work with this. You know what I mean? So we went in, made a few changes to the script or whatever. And we shot it at my house.
Oh, okay.
And that was pretty much it. It wasn't no budget. We just made it happen. You know, everybody came to the crib. You know, some people wanted some gas money, but I told them I'd hook them up next time.
But
yeah, I think it turned out pretty good. It, you know, in the acting, she did a good job in it, acting too, playing Roy.
Yes.
And Sue Ann Marie Hines.
Yeah.
Played, what was the character she played?
She played Angie.
Angie, okay. And then it was Maggie, was it? Sharisa's part, Sharisa Whiteley.
Oh,
did a good
gosh,
job
that's horrible.
Character.
I can't even remember her
name. Well, her real name
Kimmy, is... Kimmy. Her name was Kimmy, yes.
Most importantly, her real name is Teresa Whitehill.
Oh, okay, yeah.
So, yeah, everybody did a good job, man. So, I'm ready to do it again.
I am too.
I'm ready to do it again.
Yeah.
So are you all a part of a film production company, or do you just work separately and collaborate together?
We came together for that. We was talking about, you know what I mean, trying to start something up. Mm-hmm. But, you know, everybody's still trying to, you know, everybody still got money issues and stuff. Mm. So it just take time to get everybody together with no budgets going on.
Right.
So we just trying to make it happen. But, yeah, at the next film, the ball will be rolling.
Yeah.
You know what I mean, as far as going at it full steam. So.
Okay.
I'm ready. All right, ready?
Yes, I am ready. Mr. Luckett.
Speaking of films, it's time for us to check out the film. It's called Blow Out the Candles. The decorations, this is all you could bring?
Yeah. I was thinking maybe you would catch that end of it since I got the cake.
Come on, man.
You should have.
I can't do everything, you know. I arrange all of us to come together. I did my part.
Okay, all right.
I mean,
yeah,
really,
right,
come on
right.
Now. Yeah. Right, Kimmy, wouldn't you say? Kimmy, what's wrong?
I'm pregnant, y'all.
What?
I'm pregnant.
Pregnant? Is it?
It's Dorian's, isn't it?
Are you serious? What happened? When did you find out?
Please don't tell me you're pregnant by a married man.
Is it Dorian's?
Yes.
How can you be so stupid?
Oh, Lord, oh dear, oh dear. What are you going to do? Lord, help us.
She's going to the chop shop is what she's going to do. I mean, what? So what, you're gonna have a baby by a married man?
I don't know.
You don't know. You don't know. Are you really that stupid?
Roy!
No, really, why are you so stupid? I mean, you're pregnant by a married man and you don't know what you're gonna do.
Wait. Have you all talked about this? What did he say?
Yeah, we talked about it. He said that whatever I decided, he would...
Did he tell you he was going to leave his wife and kids for you? Because he ain't.
He doesn't believe in abortion. He said that if that was something that I decided, that he would support me and to pray about it. I mean, besides him and his wife, they haven't been happy for a long time now. He's been waiting for the right time to ask her for a divorce. I don't know. Maybe this could be it.
So, wait, he's getting a divorce? When?
I don't know. He said he's been waiting for the right time to ask her for one.
My God, girl, what have you gotten yourself into? Honey, is this something you really want to do? I mean, you know his wife, his kids? Do you really want to do this to yourself?
Things have not been right between them for a long time now. I mean, they don't even sleep in the same bed. He sleeps in the guest room. I mean, he says she's so concerned with appearances and material things and what other people think. He's so not like that.
You're a moron.
Roy, please. Kimmy, you must know that this is a very sticky situation, right? I mean, you are a God-fearing woman.
Church people kills me. I mean, they really kill me. It's always about what the Lord says and what the Lord wants. What do you think the Lord thinks about y'all right now? You and the deacon.
Look, I know this child is a blessing. It's a blessing from the Lord. I mean, Dorian's in a bad situation right now, but this could be what turns things around. We love each other. And I know that I bring more to this relationship than just material things.
God ain't have nothing to do with a married man having unprotected sex with an idiot.
Honey, I love you. We both do. But we don't want to see you hurt by him. I mean, he's a married man. So many lives could be ruined.
I just feel like this is a blessing for me. I mean, we love each other, and they haven't been happy, and I just know that with this baby, he's...
Baby? You're so silly. I mean, really, he'll what? He'll leave his family for you, his wife and kids? And then what, you'll be seated to the front of the church with his friends and their wives?
Roy, come on. You know what? I think you had enough to drink.
No, I'm not coming. This is ridiculous. Having a married man's baby.
Why are you so against the Lord and the church?
I'm not against the Lord and the church. I'm just against the trifling holy people that hide behind the both of them.
Roy, will you stop? Kimmy, please, please don't go. Don't go.
You don't have a clue. You just don't. You don't understand how God works. Yes, he's already married, and yes, he already has kids, but we love each other, and it's real. This is a blessing. I'm telling you, it truly is.
How, Kimmy? How?
I'm not even supposed to be able to have kids.
Thanks for the cake.
Welcome back, everyone. I sure hope that you enjoyed Blow Out the Candles. It was written by Tracy Tartt. And I thought it was an excellent film, very thought-provoking. It was like there was a message in there, especially for these young ladies, I'll say.
And older women, too.
Yeah, I forgot about us.
And I always liked how it ended, you know what I mean? I know it kind of ended abruptly as far as the story, mm-hmm. but we kind of chose to like end it on a cliffhanger to just to have maybe you form your own opinion about it. I didn't want to just close it, you know what I mean, have it a closed case, closed book. I wanted the audience to form their own opinions as far as what would you do in that situation mm-hmm. or what should she do. But you know, it got a lot of people wanting to see another episode.
Right,
though.
Right.
Exactly.
A lot of
right,
people thought exactly. it was like a web series. They yes. were like, we want to know what's going to happen next. Yeah. Yeah. I'm like, ain't nothing happening next.
Right.
That's it.
Right. And you know what? Somebody else told me, why don't you do a continuance of that? And I said, no, I don't want to do that because you'll get into a mode where you'll do Blow Out the Candles, Blow Out the Candles 1, Blow Out the Candles mm-hmm. 2. And then it's like, okay, you're not really doing anything differently. Mm-hmm. You're not being creative. You're just kind of munching off the same thing over and over.
Right.
So
no,
there will not be another Blow Out the Candles.
We are coming with some sort of scripted serial type drama or something. Okay. You know what
yes.
I mean?
It is in the works right now, actually.
So,
you know, ready for it.
People to check it out?
No, they ready. Should check it out.
Yeah.
They should check it out.
It's going to have the same type of moral mm-hmm. message yep. and stuff like that.
Yeah. And as a, in the young generation, I say they really need to check that one out.
Yeah.
Yeah, they really need to check that
out. Yeah, I got a lot of responses from people.
That's you did? Yeah.
Right. Mm-hmm. A lot of passionate responses.
Exactly. Yeah.
A lot of us older women need to watch that too.
Yeah.
Some of us older women act like we, you know,
our minds are in the yeah,
right, or in the time.
Yeah, in the wrong times.
Right.
Yeah, we're supposed to be mentoring these young people coming up, but we're right there with them.
Right.
It's like, yeah, we can't separate
Right. But, yeah.
And that was another point, too, that I wanted to bring out. Like, mm-hmm. your train of thought and your perception of things right. and how you go about making decisions. Is this a right decision? Mm-hmm. You know, the decision that I made that got me into this, yeah. you know, particular situation. What can I do to rectify it? And, you know.
Basically, think about what you're doing
yeah.
before you do it.
Right.
Yeah.
Right, and think about the consequences.
You could be blowing out the candles, too.
Yeah.
Speaking of which, what did y'all do with that cake? It was looking oh so delicious.
She tried to feed it to me and fatten me up. I'm trying to lose weight, you know what I mean? So, no, I did not eat it.
What happened to that cake?
Somebody ate it.
Let's hope somebody
ate it. It was a nice, I mean, a nice mm-hmm. chocolate, yes. double chocolate on chocolate cake. Oh.
Mm-hmm. Why you eat it?
We didn't have time. It was just so much going on. I should have eaten it, though. I should have took it back. But see, I didn't want to bring something and then take it back. Now, I don't do that.
Yeah, yeah.
Can't bring something over to somebody else and go, okay, y'all didn't need it. Well, I'm taking it back. I don't do that now.
So now, how often do you write?
You know what? I try when I'm inspired or when I'm, you know, pushed to do so. But I try to do something at least once a week.
Okay.
At least once a week, I try to get something out. And it may not be on one particular thing. It may be on several different things mm-hmm. that I have ideas on. And whatever idea pops up, then I'll just jot something down here or I'll jot something down there. But that's kind of like my writing strategy.
Okay. So do you want to share with us contact information, how we all
contact? If you want to holler at me, you can just hit me on Facebook, James Luckett.
Okay.
You'll see my picture, Alfred Hitchcock looking picture.
Oh, Lord.
You'll be looking up in the air. Or you can hit me at blipblap03@gmail.com. BLIPBLAP03@gmail.com.
All right. Tracy, how can people reach out to you?
You can reach out to me at tracy.tart@gmail. That is my email address. Mm-hmm. My Facebook is Tracy E Tart, TRACYE, period, TARTT. And that's my Facebook page. Now, my profile picture is something a little metaphysical and, you know, colorful. But, yeah, that's going to be me.
All right. Well, thank you so much, James and Tracy, for coming on the show this evening.
We had a good time.
All right. And I had a good time with you.
You didn't have a good time with me?
Oh, I'm sorry.
Wait
and
a minute.
I had an even better time with you.
Wait a minute.
Now let's go to the Atlanta Film Festival and see what's happening on the red carpet.
Hello, everyone. My name is Joyce White, and we're with Show Me Your Shorts, and we are live here at the Atlanta Film Festival. And I have here with me Ty Sheridan, who is also starring in Joe with Nicolas Cage. How are you doing this evening?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing well, thank you. Now, tell me, how was it working with Nicolas Cage? Because he happens to be one of my most favorite actors.
Oh, really? Yeah, he's one of my favorites, too. Super nice guy, super talented actor. It was great.
All right. Now, how long did it take to make this movie, Joe?
I think we shot this in 6 weeks. So, I mean, a fairly short shoot. You know, we were in and out. But I know Nick was there like a month before we even started shooting, rehearsing with David. So he was really, really, really into this film. And this is something he was really dedicated to.
Now, is this a true story?
You know, I think it may have been based off of true events. The screenplay is based off a novel by Larry Brown, which I'm sure you could ask David mm-hmm. and he'd give you some more information about. But it's based off a Southern novelist story, Larry Brown, the same title, Joe. And I think there were some changes from the novel to the screenplay, a mm-hmm. couple adaptions, but I mean, everything is pretty much the same.
All right. Now, what other films have you been involved in?
My first film, it was called The Tree of Life, and then I did a film called Mud, and now I'm here with this film called Joe. I've got some others in the can that I've just shot in August, September, November, and October. And then I just shot a movie in February. with Ewan McGregor.
Oh, wow. So, yeah. All right.
Hi, this is Joyce White with Show Me Your Shorts, and we are here live at the Atlanta Film Festival, and I am standing here with the one and only David Gordon Green. How are you doing this evening?
I'm doing good. Good to talk to you, Joyce.
Thank you. Now, this amazing film, Joe, that stars Nicolas Cage and also stars Ty Sheridan, how did you come up with the story?
Well, it's based on a novel by Larry Brown. It's been a favorite book of mine for a long time. A college professor of mine introduced me to Larry's work, and he actually, years later after Larry passed away, he adapted the novel. Gary Hawkins is a screenwriter, and he passed me his work and said, you know, let's bring one of these stories to life, and it felt like a great time and great opportunity to do it.
Oh, wow. Now, what was one of your favorite moments in this film?
Well, you know, I think the everyday pleasure of working with Nicolas Cage, Ty Sheridan, and the rest of the cast, moments like when Nick used a venomous cottonmouth snake as a prop, I thought that was kind of amazing just to see the audacity and fearlessness of one of my favorite actors, and having moments like that where you realize that, like, you know, you're putting together something really unique, really special, and working really hard with people you care about.
Wow. Now, where else do you want this film to go besides here at the Atlanta Film
Festival? Oh, Atlanta's all that matters to me.
All right. Yeah. Are you from here originally?
No, I just like coming here. But, you know, we premiered the film in Venice, Italy in August, and we've played around the world, and it's nice to come back to home. We played at South by Southwest in Austin where we filmed it. Last month, and to be here and start spreading the word about the movie, it's just real important to us.
Now it's time for us to head on in to check out the movie called Joe. Hello, I'm here with Lisa Williams, and we have just finished seeing the movie called Joe. Now, Lisa, tell me what you thought about the film.
No, it's a good movie. You know, that's, I guess a little, some people are saying it might be a little bit too slow, but I think you gotta set up the characters. Like, you know, you gotta set up the story. So, I mean, once it got rolling, I thought it was really exciting. It was emotional. I mean, it was well done, well shot, so well acted. If it can evoke some emotion out of somebody, I think they've done their job. So I really dug it. Yeah, it's a good movie.
All right. Good movie. So would you recommend it to someone else?
Oh, yeah. Absolutely, yeah. Everybody go see Joe.
There we go.
Everybody, here you go. Everybody go see it. It's a good movie.
I'm here with Gabriel Pressman. And you've just seen Joe. Can you give us your thoughts on the movie?
Yeah, I thought it was amazing. I thought the way they used non-traditional actors really added a lot to the movie. It made you really believe what was going on screen, and I thought he did a tremendous job portraying a very complex story.
I thought Joe was a very good character. I really liked Joe in the movie. Joe made the movie. Mm-hmm. You know, I've watched Nicolas Cage for years and years, and he was kind of different in this particular role, but he was very good.
Yes, he was.
And
yes,
I enjoyed it.
Very comical.
Exactly.
All right. And, sir, can you tell us your thoughts on Joe?
Sure. I thought it was a pretty good movie. You know, I'm typically not into the slower type, more of an action guy, and it really kept me very interested and entertained. I really enjoyed it. I especially enjoyed the father.
Yes.
He did a really good job. It was a great movie. Great, well put together movie. I enjoyed it.
Now, hi. We're here with
Chell Steven.
Well, what did you think of that movie, Joe?
I thought it was awesome. I'm a big fan of David Gordon Green's work, and I think Nicolas Cage and Ty Sheridan are amazing. It was really cool to see them really dive deep into those performances. I thought it was great.
Wow. Now, would you recommend that someone run out and see this film?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, I think there's kind of something for everyone in it. It has those dark moments, but then there's also really moments of lightness and laughter, and I think, I don't know, that's what life is like, too. I think there's something for everybody there, and the performances are just that strong that it's worth seeing if you like great performances, and who doesn't?
I do, and I love Nicolas Cage.
He's amazing. He's the best. Hi, guys. I'm Myreem here with Show Me Your Short, and next to me I have Mr.
Taylor OMB.
And Taylor is part of the film industry. He's going to tell us a little bit of more of what he does and his involvement in the Atlanta Film Festival.
Sure. Well, we did some panels for the festival. We did a legal and finance panel as well as a documentary panel. And we also have a great Young Mavericks representative with Matchbook and with Film South, Jan Mullins, who's phenomenal. Like, you've got to catch that out on Sunday. But we work really hard. I started as a publicist and then went into producing with my partner, Katie Gathman. She's phenomenal as well. You met her earlier, you
I
know.
Did. Very
yeah,
nice
she's
gal.
Cool. And so we work on a variety of projects, film, television, shorts. We do have some shorts out now that we've done, mainly as what's called a proof of concept, which when you're looking to pitch a project to a network, whether it's a television show or maybe a studio if it's a film, one good stepping stone in your process is to shoot a shorter version of almost like a trailer or a sizzle reel of your project to pitch it for investors, for distribution. That's something that we work on from projects, whether it's a script or an idea, from concept to completion. And that involves everything from pre-production to post, marketing, building a campaign around your project.
That's like a busy schedule.
Very busy. It's amazing that we are here for the time that we are here. We do a lot of festivals as well. We just wrapped Macon. We were out in LA for the Academy Awards doing some things there.
Oh, that's very cool.
It was a lot of fun. And then now we're looking forward to what's coming up with the Atlanta Film Festival. This has been my first year here. And Katie's first year. Yeah, it's our pleasure. Chris Escobar, Rebecca Baker, Ashley Epting, all the staff and the volunteers here have just been incredible. This is an amazing event, and it's something that I think makes Atlanta look really good in the national and international community here for film and television.
Definitely. So that sounds like you're coming back next year then.
Absolutely, definitely.
So what else do you and your partner are involved with?
Okay, we work with a couple of projects. One is a feature called Come On In, We're Dead. We're also working on a SAG series called Intrepid Academy. We did the pilot shoot last summer, which is awesome. We've got distribution now, so we're going into production later this year for our episodes, which is about a school for superheroes, so it's kind of fun, you know. And we work with Film South. And that's something that I'm really passionate about, as well as the Georgia Production Partnership. They're a phenomenal organization. But our mission is to empower entertainment professionals here in our region to compete globally through education, training, and workforce development. Here in the state of Georgia alone, we have a $3.5 billion industry. You know, that's great. But we want to see more Georgians and more people in our region working, you know. Let's quit importing talent and exporting jobs.
Definitely.
Let's put the people that are here to work. Let's train them, let's educate them, let's get them on jobs so that we can save these production companies and these studios and networks money, you know, for flying people in and out and start building up our talent pool here, because it's a phenomenal talent pool here.
Yeah,
from behind the lens to in front of the lens.
Right.
These people have amazing talents and gifts, and Our primary mission is to locate those people and develop those talents and gifts.
And finally recognize them.
Exactly.
Yeah.
You
All
got
right.
it. Yeah.
Well, thank you so much for talking to us, Taylor.
Yeah.
I'm going to let you go back and enjoy today. You know, it's definitely going to be a busy day, busy week.
Yeah.
I mean, we're here until
9 days.
Exactly.
Yeah, one
we're
day down,
until,
nine to go. Yeah.
We're here a whole week. But thank you so much for being involved with
it's
us.
It's my pleasure, Maureen.
Yes, definitely.
Maureen, yeah.
And guys, stick around for more.
If you have a short film that you want featured on our show, go to www.showmeyourshorts.com. Click on the contact page and send us an email. Like us on Facebook at facebook.com/showmeyourshorts. And to all my aspiring filmmakers, don't wait for the magic hour. Just pick up the camera and shoot. I'm Joyce White, and you've been watching Show Me Your Shorts.
They say that home is where the heart is, but lately, my heart hasn't found a home. After leaving Florida and moving to Atlanta to pursue my dreams, I now have to navigate my way through the challenges of living with family, making new friends.
Hey, Joanna, right?
Right?
Yeah. She works hard for money.
Speed date? Yeah, you should come.
Rediscovering romance.
Your lips, they look like two apples. Kissing.
Sorry, what was your name?
smart.
I'm Joanne.
How about I be out of your house by tomorrow morning?
And landing the ultimate gig.
You work for Tyler Perry?
Are you thinking about coming here? Because I want to teach you some things personally.
Okay, because I round up all the single women in the church.
What?
And we have one-on-one Bible study.
No one ever told me that life would be so complex.